In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of brachial plexus and relationship with brachial plexus. I am going to explain anatomy of scaling, especially anterior scaling and middle scaling. Why is that so important? Because middle scaling and anterior scaling run like this, anterior scaling and middle scaling. Brachial plexus passes between anterior scaling and middle scaling. So being able to palpate this place is very important for neck pain, arm pain, shoulder pain, or thoracic outlet syndrome. Then how do I find brachial plexus? There is a vein here, very superficial vein, external jugular vein. You can see the most of the people, external jugular vein. Now about here, this is external jugular vein. Let's say this blue pen is vein, brachial plexus runs deep to external jugular vein. So if you can find external jugular vein, put finger on it, you are automatically on brachial plexus. You can see the vein almost everybody. If you don't see somebody's vein, please choose other people for practice. Okay, this is external jugular vein. Deep to this vein, there is brachial plexus. But how do you know this is nerve or this is muscle? Okay, remember the relationship? I am on brachial plexus. From here, go anteriorly. There should be scaling anterior. Or go back, there should be middle scaling. How do I know? I ask person to breathe in. So this person is breathing. Now I feel muscle contraction on my thumb. That means I am on scaling. Why? Because scaling attaches on the rib cage. You know, this muscle is used for breathing. If person breathing and I feel contraction, I am on scaling. Especially I am on middle scaling because I was on the brachial plexus and I did go to the posterior part. This is middle scaling. I'll go back to brachial plexus, ask him to breathe in. Now I don't feel contraction. That means I am on the nerve. Why? Because nerve does not contract. Okay. Now I go anteriorly. I should be on anterior scaling. I ask him to breathe in. I feel contraction here. That means I am on anterior scaling. I will explain the relationship again. External jugular vein. Deep to external jugular vein, there is brachial plexus. If you can find external jugular vein, you automatically can find brachial plexus. From anterior from brachial plexus, there is scaling anterior, anterior scaling. From posterior from brachial plexus, there is middle scaling because relationship is like this. Anterior scaling, middle scaling, brachial plexus. Okay, external jugular vein, brachial plexus, go anterior, anterior scaling, from brachial plexus, go to posterior, this is middle scaling. This relationship is very important. You should be able to differentiate these tissues. So this is it. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.